Hello friends, how are you? Today I will tell you how to change the electronic card of motorized actuator. You can see this is the motorized actuator of Bernard. It's a German company. You can see I am removing this main card of this actuator. Function of this card is to move the motor in the reverse and the forward direction. So it will open or close the damper. As you know, this motorized actuator is used to open or close the damper. So I will remove this electronic card. You can see these are jacks. I am just removing the jacks. You can see there are so many jacks. Each jack as cables. I remove the jack of commands that go command to the magnetic contactor reverse and forward. Now I am removing this signaling jack. Then there are limit switch jack, and you can see I am removing these jacks. After removing these jacks, I will replace this electronic card because this card is faulty. If this card is faulty, our actuator will not move on auto and it will also not move on manual. So if actuator is not moving on auto and manual, most probably this electronic card is faulty. There may be other causes, but I think 90% chances that this electronic card is faulty. So I am removing this card. You can see I am removing jacks. After removing jacks, I will replace this card. You can see it's very easy. This is the card which I will install. It's a new card, and you can see there are dip switches for the settings. This cable is the supply of GAMIC card. You know GAMIC card gives milliamps, and its input is potentiometer. It takes set point from the CCR and gives feedback to the CCR in 4 to 20 milliamp signal. And this was the jack of that GAMIC card supply. You can see almost all cables are removed. There are three more cables which are terminated in this connector. This is cable for supply of this card. It's 440 supply. You can see this card is faulty. So now I will install this new card. First of all, I will connect these three cables in this connector. This is supply of this card, S440 supply. You can also connect 220 volt, but for this you have to change its setting through the jumpers. Now I am connecting the three cables. After that, I have connected the jack of its supply, 19 volt and 24 volt. It has two types of supplies, 440 volts and 19 and 24 volts. Now I am connecting all the jacks. After connecting jacks, I will fix this card. Almost all jacks are connected. Just press these jacks and they will be fixed. It's very easy to fix these connectors, these jacks. There are pins downside and these jacks are fitted on that pins. Just fix them with care, otherwise pin will be bent and it will not proper way. Almost finished. This card is fitted. This is a GAMIC card. I will also replace this GAMIC card because this is a Bernard original card, and now I fixed Chinese card. because these Bernard cards don't match with this Chinese card. So I will also replace this small card, which is a gimmick card. It gave 4 to 20 milliampere. At that point is also 4 to 20 milliamps, and it has potentiometer input. It converts resistance into milliamps and gave signal to the main card whether to start actuator in opening position or closing position. Now I am removing this gimmick card. This is a small card, you can see. This is a gimmick card. So I will replace this card with same Chinese card. Function of both card is same, but the company is different. This is original Bernard card. Now I am fixing this new card. After that we will check whether this actuator works or not. You can see I will just screw it on this plate, and then I will connect potentiometer jack and signaling jack, which is set point 4 to 20 and feedback 4 to 20 to the CCR, and then I will connect its supply jack, which is supply of this card. So hope you understand how to change electronic card of Bernard actuators. This is a motorized actuator. It is used to open or close a damper, mechanical damper, and this is electrical actuator. It supplies 3-phase 440 volt. You can see motor. This motor is 3-phase 440 volt. And these electronics cards are used to run this motor in reverse or forward direction. It follows the set point from the CCR. Its set point is 4 to 20 milliamps. It's 0 to 100%. This actuator moves 0 to 100%. We can operate at 0%, 10%, 20%, which we required. You can see now I am fixing this screws are fitted now. Now I will check after switching on the supply. I will check, this is its manual switch. You can see you can open or close through this switch. This is a red switch. It's on remote position. In remote position it will follow the set point. You can see jack, and on the manual position you can operate it with the other manual switch. You can open it or you can close it. So I am connecting the jack of this manual selector switch board. I have connected it. Now the supply is on. Now I will check whether its calibration is okay or not. You can see I am checking the milliamps. This is the set point, 14.23. Now I will check its calibration, whether it's okay or not. I will check its set point and its feedback. Both should be same. If they are not same, then I will calibrate this motorized actuator. You can see its position, it's on zero position, it's fully closed. You can see set point is 19, and this motor is actuator also moved. Its calibration is not okay. Now I will calibrate it for you. Just see carefully how to calibrate actuator. I am moving it. I will close it, and on the 0% I will adjust its 4 milliamps with this potentiometer. You can see in the little electronic card. And first of all, this is on 25%, but I want to close it 0%. I am adjusting its gain because its limit was operated. Now it's closing more. I have adjusted its gain with screwdriver. You can see it's very easy to adjust. Just press and rotate. You can see I am checking its feedback. Set point is 15, at set point is 20, sorry, and its feedback is 7.1. Here it should be 4, so I will adjust it to the 4 milliamps, and this will be zero calibration of this actuator. I will adjust it 0. Again, I am checking its calibration is okay or not. It's not okay because on 0 it's showing 7 milliamps. I will adjust it to the 4 milliamps through this potentiometer with the screwdriver. I am adjusting it. You can see with the screwdriver, I am adjusting its milliamps on this potentiometer. Always adjust 0 with this potentiometer and span on the card. There is a potentiometer on the card and it's marked 100%. From there you can adjust its span, and 0 is always adjusted from this potentiometer on this game. If you will not adjust it on the potentiometer, and if you adjust 0 on the card, your calibration will not be okay. You can see at 100%, set point 20 and feedback also 20, so its span is okay, no need to adjust. As you can see, gaming card, it has potentiometer to adjust span, but now we don't need to adjust its span. You can see this actuator is closing and opening again and again because its dead band is not okay. I will increase its dead band setting. On gaming card there is a potentiometer to adjust dead band. It's opening and closing again and again. This is very dangerous situation. I will adjust it dead band through this potentiometer on this card. Now it's okay. I have increased its dead band setting. Now I am checking. I have closed it a little bit and now I am opening it. Now I will check whether it stays on its position or again it moves. It's okay now. Now I am closing. So our actuator is calibrated 100%. Its cords are changed. I have told you how to change electronic cards, and also I have told you how to calibrate and how to adjust the dead band of motorized actuator. This, you can see, this is faulty card because of high temperature. This card is become faulty, but now